Hi, this is George with NS345. Today I'm mixing the guitars. This is my mix series 3. I'm mixing the song Ready to Begin by Houston's band Zion Road. If you haven't done so already, please join our Facebook group. It is a closed private group where we just chat it out about different topics, and it's just a small, really small community at this moment, just talking about the mix or talking about any other things, from silly questions to maybe more advanced questions, but no question is too dumb. So if you can join us at NS345 Music Facebook group, that'll be great. The link will be at the bottom on the comments. Also, we have a like page that you can go ahead and like and keep up with what I'm doing around the studio. Another thing that's worth mentioning is if you follow Graham Cochran from The Recording Revolution, just recently he's challenged everyone or whoever wants to do it to write a song per month for the next 12 months or for all of 2016. And basically, he's putting a video series together where he goes through his process. I thought it was pretty cool, so I've actually committed to doing that. So I will be putting out a song per month, and I'm going to be hopefully be doing videos about it the same way I do the videos for the mix series. So hopefully you'll get to see that. So be on the lookout for that. I plan on having that by the end of the month. I'm going to try to get one of my regular videos posted, as well as one of the videos showing my songwriting workflow, recording it, mixing it, and mastering it to be able to release it on SoundCloud or something like that. Today, I'm back on the song Ready to Begin, and I'm going to be working on the guitars. You can see there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 9 guitar parts, 26, 27, 28, and 29 are rhythm. And it seems like it's 2 different tones. I was just listening to it a little bit ago. And then this part just does an ostinato type pattern. Here you have an arpeggiated guitar and a little bit of tremolo. And then you have a lead part here. So let's just listen to it individually. So let's start on the arpeggiated guitar. Okay, I really like this arpeggiated tone. Okay, let's hear the lead guitar. Okay, and then again, this part, the arpeggio. Okay, and the lead here. Here comes the solo. Okay, and then this part. Okay, so let's hear the rhythm guitars. Hear the 4 of them. As you can hear, it's just 2 different tones. They almost look identical. Okay, what happens here? Let me listen to them individually. Okay, so I've got to make a decision here because I can muddy up the mix with these guitars. So let's hear them in context. Oh, and the last one here. Okay, so that's just a lower register type guitar picking. And this part does the same thing. All right. Oh, where to go? Okay, so I think I'm going to start with the rhythm. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to listen real quick. Okay, they're all routed to my guitar bus here. I don't need any compression just now. But what I'm going to do is, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pan them. So I'm going to pan 26 left. See what happens there. And then 27, I'm going to pan hard right. See what that sounds like. Okay, and then I've got the other two, which actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to pan the 28 and 29. I'm going to pan them left and right. And then 26 and 27, I'm going to bring them in a little bit. So about 50 and 50 on the 27. Okay, let's see what that sounds like. So it looks like it opened up. Let's hear it in the mix. All right, so I'm going to work with the rhythm, and I'm going to take them one at a time. Let me try these two. I'm just going to go to the reference track real quick. Start with the rhythm guitar. So I don't need any compression on this. It's pretty compressed, as you can see the waveform there. So what to do? So EQ wise is good. Okay, so maybe just it's already compressed enough. So no, let me get out of there. Let me put some delay on this. I know it's goofy, but let's try it, see what happens. Solo this one and make sure I send it to my guitars. Right there. So I'm gonna use the H delay. Okay, so I just need it to be barely audible. I'm just trying to create a room tone maybe, or a little bit of space so it doesn't sound so boring. Okay, and now I'm gonna add a little reverb. And before I do that, I'm gonna say follow the panning of the track. So follow main pan. So if it's pan left, this one right now, I have a pan center just for the, just to work on it. But once I pan it to the left, the reverb, the delay and the reverb is going to follow it that way. So that way I can create more of a stereo image. So I'll leave it pan for now. Now I'm going to add a reverb, the reverb. So solo safe, I'm going to make sure I send this to my guitar bus. So I'm going to throw in the Avid. I already know which reverb I'm going to use, which is the Avid Studio Reverb. This one. Okay. See what that does. Okay, so I like that, and I'm gonna try to shape the other one in a different tone to make sure it doesn't sound too boring. And what I'm gonna do is actually, I'm gonna bring in the same delay and reverb, and because I'm gonna pan it to the left, to the right, you should hear a nice difference. Thank you. Okay, so this is the EQ I used on the left, and this one's the EQ I used on the right. And very similar, just a quick notch here, and just a quick push on the top end there. And then the delay is about the same. And this is with all the plugins bypassed. So they're a little dark just now, but that's okay. Because I'm going to try to make the other ones maybe a tad brighter. Or we'll see how it works. But what I am going to do is let me come back to it. I'm probably going to do some parallel compression, maybe just to bring up a little bit of the tone that I'm after. So let me go to the other two rhythm tracks for now. And let's just hear those. These are a bit more grungy, so I don't want to mess with them too much. And I'm going to use a different EQ just for color. Boo, 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 boo. What do I have? Let me use the SSL EQ. Right track. So let's hear them together. Okay. Pan them left and right. Okay, so bypassed. So the EQ did clean him up really nice, but it may have taken some of the low end away, but I can fix that. Maybe with a little bit of parallel compression. And let's just see what that does. But first I want to try the same delay and reverb on this one that I added on the previous two tracks. Okay, so I have all four tracks selected. I'm going to move this under here, just under the rhythm guitars, and I'll select all four tracks. And I can bypass all the plugins by holding Shift Control Option. Okay, so make sure they're all panned. Yep. But I have them all panned. At 100, I don't want that. Bring this one to 50. Okay. Okay, so notice how they disappear once I bypass. With all the plugins, they just completely disappear from the mix. Then I'll bring the plugins in halfway. And if you look at my meter here, my guitar bus is not changing much. Here I am, on my own, still waiting for you. I'm ready to give in. So it's not adding any gain or taking away any gain. Okay, so that sounds okay for now. what I want to do, what I want to do, what I want to do. Parallel compression, maybe, maybe not. Should I do it on all four guitars or two? What I do. Parallel compression, mono. I'm actually going to send a little bit of the signal. I'll send. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bus all these guitars together. The four. Okay, that's what I'll do. So I'll, instead of sending them to the guitars, I'll take these four and I'll send them to my parallel compression bus that I just created. It should be at the bottom. Oh, but I created a mono. So what I'm gonna do here is create a new track, parallel compression, get stereo. So I've got two things now. I've got a bus here. So I've got the delays 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the bus. This is going to the guitars. No, I messed that up, didn't I? Well, I could just rename that. Rhythm guitars. And then this is going to the guitars. But now, okay, I got you. Send them all to the stereo P-comp guitars. Sorry about that. Okay, so let's see what this does. Multi-mono harmonics. Gray compressor, not green. There we go. Here we go. One more. Yeah. I'm going to smooth it out with some tape. All right, so let's see what we can do with that. Oh, sounds really good. Maybe it's just my ears, but... Well, I can take myself, look back in time. Okay, so that sounds okay. What do you think? I think it sounds good. Okay, well, let me get working on the other ones real quick. Let's work on the intro one. I already know what I'm hearing there. I know what I'm hearing. So let's just do a little bit of EQ. Renaissance. Thank you. modulation. What do we have here? I had like an octave or something like that. Another. Okay, and I'm gonna bring in a little bit of the original signal. Back in. Okay, without the plugins. All right, bring in a little tape. Actually, can I put it here? line and a little distortion back into it. For now, that's okay. And again, a little reverb. I don't know what the deal is with the reverb. There we All right, let me go to work on this. Hey, man, that sounds so nice. Thank you. So I use that one just for the filter because the AE400 does not have it. So that little click that the delay is causing, I'm going to get rid of that. That. I know that's part of playing, and that's it actually sounds quite nice, but I just don't want it in the mix right now. Right now. A little better. I'm gonna add just a touch of reverb. Just a touch. Same reverb here. That little whistling. Yeah, I don't really like that whistling. Okay, same reverb. That's why I'm gonna use some parallel compression. I could get the track going. Mono.
Thank you.
I've gotten all the guitars. I need to go back and work on this. I spent too much time on it today. To be honest, my ears are tired already.
See you soon, peeps.